So. Time expire. I shouldn't have done that on triple speed. That was dumb. So right 36, left to 10, right to 59, and then right to 97. So we are going to hold off on getting Vincent until later, because we can do him at any time. We don't have to do him right now. Anyway, you get back to Nibelheim, and it's not the same at all. Because last time it was all burned to crap. Here's Tifa's house. There's a bunch of these shadowy guys running around. Okay, let's jam on the piano a little bit. Thank you. just going to go right through. And we're going to save here because there's a boss coming up that will fuck our shit. One of the hardest bosses for a speedrun of this game.
Right.
Basically, you poison him, keep healing, and honestly, I had hoped I would be able to do him to do shrine on me. But that did not end up working out, so. But, yeah, we're going this way. Don't want to go into the forest until after the date scene, because that's where you're going to end up getting yuppie. Picking sunflower seeds by the bottom of the bag. Give me just a second here, because I have a small dog and I don't want to eat any of these. So let's get a trigger. Do a couple dialogue sequences with City here, but I'm just going to do the one that triggers. Okay, so no, you cannot borrow the Tiny Bronco. His exact words are, "You out of your fucking mind." Space got crushed. So that it can be explained how. Sit down in those chairs and drink your goddamn tea. And the rocket fell over. And that's why it leans. We'll be right back. Now I'm not going to bother go getting it, so I'll explain it now. North of Junon. It's either north of Junon or north of, whatchamacallit. Yeah, it's got to be over there. There's a cave that you can only get to by taking the little sand buggy back over there. And you go up there, and there's a dude in the cave that will tell you how many battles you fought. Up super north of here, there's a cave that you can go into. It'll tell you how many battles you fought. The last two digits are odd and the same, then he will give you an item called a mithril, which you then take to this house right here. And he trades you, gives you the option of either a big chest or a small chest. Small chest is on the wall on the far right side. You take that option, and that is where Gareth's final maneuver gets. So let's save real quick. Because after we get up here, we no longer have the option to build anything. That's always fun. Sometimes I get to move in too fast for my own good. Now, if you go in there, he's also the guy that has the stuff that you think. He'll tell you if you say it to which is why we're going up to the gold saucer. And we got the Barrett date. He's just been a puppet for someone who should have been destroyed. And that, ladies and gents, I am going to call a day. I will catch you later.